today, October 12th, 2014, to remind the world of what took place on our continent and what has been taking place since October 12th, 1492. Christopher Columbus initiated the biggest genocide ever witnessed by humanity, killing 70 to 100 million of our people. Yet this country, this colonial country, continues to celebrate him. People have been kept ignorant of that history. We have been kept ignorant of the very, very fact that we are indigenous. They want to call us Hispanic because we speak Spanish. They want to call us Latinos. But we are indigenous people. We are the Mixteca people. Whether you are from El Salvador, Guatemala, New York, Honduras, Colombia, Bolivia, we are an indigenous people. Christopher Columbus and his men used biological warfare to kill us in the millions. Smallpox was a weapon of mass destruction. They knew very well what they were doing with smallpox. In addition, the killing of our leadership, the killing of our people in the millions, the burning of our universities, the burning of our books, blessed by the Catholic Church, which is why we are going to march over to the cathedral and protest the cathedral for the crimes committed by the church. The fact that every action committed of genocide was blessed by the church. We need to confront them. We need to hold them accountable for the lies being perpetrated against our people. We are here to remind the world that we are indigenous, whether we be full blood or mixed blood. That does not rob us from our ownership to this land. When they call us illegals, when the true illegal immigration started in 1492, and it has continued. Their illegal immigration of our continent has continued to 2014. We're also going to confront the Christopher Columbus statue at the LA Civic Mall, and ending our rally back here. Because Placita Aldera is a Spanish settlement. This is not to honor the indigenous people. This was not built to honor our people. It was built to keep killing our people. The missions were concentration camps. This was genocide. The fact that we don't know our history is genocide. They created rules and laws to keep us ignorant of our history. We are living 5 centuries of occupation and genocide. We're not leaving. For all those people that have a problem with our people being here, get used to it. They complain there's too many of us. Well, you killed 95% of our population. Imagine how many more of us there would have been. We are an indigenous people, Mexican, Central American, Native American, South American. We are an indigenous people, Nica, Tlaxca, We are Mikan Tlaka, survivors of the world's largest genocide. But to this day, they don't consider what happened to us a genocide. It's not defined by genocide by the history textbooks. How can they define this as genocide when it's the land that they're on, the resources that they keep stealing? But we know the definition of genocide because we live it every day. After Raphael Lemkin's definition, the man who created and coined the term genocide, we fit the description and definition of genocide. The theft of resources, theft of our land, theft of our education, of our languages, of our identity.